today on Florida Sport Fishing.
Oh, there's a sailfish. Already got a bite. Look, watch. Watch, 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 watch.
Ridiculous.
Oh, tight, tight.
Are you?
Tight, right there, dude. He just grabbed it.
What did I tell you? Any second.
Now you can really get a good look at those dentures.
Savage killers. That's what these king mackerel are. Just cruise around, crushing everything that they can catch. Get yourself some of that right there, baby. Right there.
Ho ho, one on!
SeaVee Boats presents Florida Sport Fishing, television for the avid angler. Powered by Mercury Marine.
There's a sailfish, already got a bite.
Ridiculous.
Another one on, another one on!
Woo! Nice, that's what it's all about right there.
Yeah.
Oh, look at that, look at that.
Florida Sport Fishing utilizes and proudly endorses Ghost, the global leader in boat security, monitoring, tracking, and surveillance. VMC. Tired of missed strikes? Fish the hooks the pros fish. Fish VMC. Fortress, the world's best anchor. Stronger, faster, lighter. Motor Guide, the most dependable trolling motors on the water. And Stingray Tackle, shop where the pros shop. Shop at stingraytackle.com.
All right, baby, we're going kite fishing.
Let's do it.
Let's do it. Nice day, a little brisk. Yeah. That's for sure.
Sailfish brisk.
Yeah, sailfish brisk is right. Yeah. Got a little bit of a northwest breeze, nice clean water on the beach. I think we'll run up north, see if we can find a nice edge, something worth stopping on, you know what I mean?
Yep.
Bite's been all right lately. There have been some sailfish around, a couple wahoo, some dolphin, a few kings mixed in.
Nice little mixed bag.
Yep. So let's go up there, get a couple kites in the air. It's going to be a little bit of ride. Hold on, because here we go.
Let's do it.
Swelly.
Yep.
It's a little swelly. That's good, though.
Oh, yeah.
To be good. Perfect. For fishing. For fishing, it'll be phenomenal. I feel some good action coming today.
So we just stopped. We're getting set up. Mike's got his kite up back there. I've got mine off the bow up here. And we're gonna see if we can catch some fishies off these kites. It's nice and brisk. And we're just gonna let it out nice and easy. Because if you you force this too heavy, you wanna keep your bait in the water if you can, just to keep him frisky on the way out to his demise, so to speak. You see, you just nice and easily walking him along the surface just like that. That's what you want to do. We're kind of lucky that we have a nice steady wind this morning. That always makes it a little easier. All right, we got one out. Here comes number two. Risky goggle eyes. And we're bridling these things. We're not even putting the hook in them. So it's just kind of dangling. You just run the needle through them like that. Then you grab your hook. We're just using a 7.0 VMC here with like 18 inches of wire as a trace. I think it's 60 pound wire we're using today. Just a couple twists, run it back through like that, right underneath the rubber band. Hook's not even in the bait. Doesn't get any friskier than that. You just let him out nice and easy. This one already wants to go meet up with Mike's bait. See him? You get some that kind of lose track. That's okay, keeps it entertaining. Just like that, nice and steady. You don't need to rush this. You walk it out nice and easy, and once it's out there, you're good. You just gotta wait for a bite. And today, it shouldn't take too long. I'm pretty sure we should get a bite here soon. The conditions are nice. Also, make sure you check your drags. Not too tight, not too loose, right in between.
Oh, there's a sailfish. Already got a bite. Look, watch. Watch. Long rod. Long rod. Look. I'm on. You get it? Yeah, I'm on. I'm in.
You hooked up?
Yeah, I'm in.
Sweet.
Yeah.
Nice job, dude. What did that take? Couple seconds?
Dude, I told you. Not even.
What do you got?
Sailfish. That was awesome, dude.
Ridiculous.
I couldn't have acted out better than that. Yeah, he's just getting happy.
How long did that take you? Just 2 minutes?
I mean, not even. I couldn't get out the second bait, man. We were just getting out. And boom, I already see his bill swiping at the bait.
Just take your time. There you go, Carlos. Nice job, dude.
Yeah, buddy.
That's what kite fishing's about, right there.
Oh, he's coming right out the boat. He's getting mad now. Yeah, buddy.
Yeah, oh, look how lit up he is, how nice and gold.
Not a monster, but he was spunky. It's nice and oh, look at this. Turtle coming in right behind him. Big old turtle. Oh,
there he goes. Perfect.
Dude, that was awesome.
That was perfect.
And there he goes, swimming away. That worked out nice.
The Mercury Verado, outstanding corrosion protection, proven reliability.
Yeah.
And it comes with all this. Meet Tom from customer support. Whoa, he's a hugger.
Not really into that, Tom, thank you.
This is Nick from field testing, runs these babies thousands of hours.
They're solid.
Nick, this is Cheryl and Bobby, our prop engineer. He turns horsepower into performance. Oh, and the rest of the gang's here.
It's good to have Mercury behind you. Meet the rest of the team at mercurymarine.com.
Tom.
The hugger.
The secret's out. Start with brine and bite, the only brine that infuses proven bite stimulants into any rigged bait. Procure badass bait dyes are next, and bring Ballyhoo to life with vibrant fluorescent colors. Seal the deal with Procure's new Bloody Tuna Oil and watch your catch ratio soar. Inshore and offshore, Procure bait scents and badass bait dyes keep you hooked up. Find Procure at your favorite dealer or call 800-PROCURE for a free catalog.
Looking for an elegant showpiece for your home, business, or yacht? Crystal Glass Company creates exquisite fine art glass for homes, restaurants, and luxury yachts. Dazzle guests with incomparable quality and detail, etched, carved, or painted on glass or mirror. Add LED lights for a stunning result. Design a custom piece to commemorate a trophy catch, or let our artist handcraft a piece of fine art glass just for you. Visit crystalglasscompany.com and prepare to be inspired.
Chaos is tragic. Chaos can be awesome.
Yo, another one on! Three on, baby!
With Chaos Fishing, it's your rod your way. Quality components and personalized service from a legendary builder equal the right rod at the right price every time. Shop online for a complete selection of serious fishing equipment. Or visit Chaos's new superstore and receive a free t-shirt with every rod purchase. Chaos Fishing, gear matters.
So Carlos, he's inflating a couple of helium balloons that we're gonna put on our kites. I'm gonna feed out a flat line real quick while he does that. And what those balloons do, as he mentioned earlier, the wind kind of slacked off just a little bit. So the balloons help keep that kite aloft, keep it stabilized, allowing us to dangle two or three baits from each kite. You think that's a big help, Carlos, that helium?
Absolutely. Especially when the wind's not consistent like it is today. It was blowing a little steady this morning, but now it's trickling down again. I'm sure it'll bump back up by the afternoon, but this is, like I said, the backup plan.
Right.
So,
got a little swell here, northwest wind. We're fishing 130 to 140 feet of water. fishing goggle eyes. We might fish some pilchards later as well.
All I'm doing is just making a quick little knot just to snug it in. This could break away. It's just a rubber band right now that's holding it. The main deal that's gonna hold it is that bridle that Mike's holding in his hand. We're good there, yep.
So from there, the balloon is fastened to the kite, right the center. And then we've got a little bridle right here, a little piece of 30-pound monofilament.
Oh, you just put it towards the top of the kite.
Got it?
Yep, just like that.
Okay.
Just put a piece right there, nice and easy. Yep. Make our little Pirate X. That's it.
There we go.
Okay, all right.
Black electrical tape, that's the only thing that's gonna work. Don't use duct tape or scotch tape. You've gotta use that black electrical tape. That's really important.
And to snug it up on this side, I just went through the kite spar.
Just did some half hitches?
Just some half hitches. Three or four of those and you're good.
Got it.
I mean, you wanna trim it close too, because you don't want the tag end popping around, because this will pop a balloon, believe it or not.
And we're gonna go now on this side and put another piece right there. And then we should be pretty much all set.
All right, go fly kite.
Good. So what we're gonna do is bridle our bait. We've got a VMC 80 live bait hook. We've got a rubber band right around the bend of the hook, right to a rigging needle, ready to go. I'm gonna reach into the well, grab a gog. This guy looks like a good candidate right here. And because we're flying him off the kite, we wanna hook him pretty much right in the back shoulder area. You don't wanna hook him up front because then he'll dangle nose first. Turn it a couple of times, put the hook right under the rubber band. So now the only thing really holding that bait on is that rubber band. And let's get him in the water pretty quickly. Right in the release clip right there. Okay, and that's gonna pop open just like that when a fish eats that bait. And then we're gonna slowly let this kite fly up. We've got our reel and free spool. And simultaneously, we're gonna let it all the way up while letting out that line right till we get to the second kite clip. So this is our far bait right now. It's got a perfect presentation right out there, right up on the surface. And I'm gonna grab another rod and do the exact same thing again. And this way we can fly two baits off of each kite. We've got this in free spool. Pop it on our other clip. And we're gonna send them both flying. And again, remember, you've got to be in free spool. You want to keep your baits right up on the surface. They don't have to be splashing directly on the surface, but close to the surface. As a matter of fact, I like them a little bit below the surface. Hey guys, we're going to keep working this edge, keep working our kite bait. Stick around, let's check out our rigging station and take a closer look at the tackle that we're fishing today.
Rigging Station, presented by Diamond Fishing Products, makers of the finest monofilament and braided fishing line in the world.
Kite fishing is a really awesome tactic. It's a lot of fun. It's a great approach and a great presentation for a variety of different pelagic predators, dolphin, kingfish, wahoo, sailfish, blackfin tuna. We've said it over and over. Having the right tools for the job certainly leans the odds in your favor. We're fishing 7-foot Chaos composite rods rated for 15 to 30 pound line. We've got the rod matched to a Daiwa Salty size 50 reel. What's key is that it's a high speed reel, a 6.4 to 1 gear ratio. Really important when you get a bite and you've got to reel up all of that slack. Remember, your line is going all the way up to that kite clip and then straight down into the water. You get a bite, you've got to get that line and reel up all of that slack as fast as possible. And that's where that high speed reel comes into play. We've got our reels loaded with fresh 30 pound Mamoy Diamond line. Our rig is pretty simple. We've got our actual running line tied to a small little snap swivel. But before we tie it off to that snap swivel, there's a couple of key little components that we have to slide up on the line. First is a small ceramic ring. That's actually what's gonna clip right to the release clip on your kite line. This way that release clip doesn't damage or chafe your running line. From there, we've got a small egg sinker. And like I said before, it's all about balance. If you don't have a lot of wind and you're struggling to keep those baits up, you might have to eliminate that weight altogether. If you have a stiff breeze, you can maybe bump that egg sinker up to a quarter, maybe even a half ounce. And that just helps keep that presentation vertical, straight up and down, and it helps keep that bait in the water. But prior to tying the swivel on, we slide a little bead up the line just to protect the knot.
Also, you'll see, I like to use these streamers. Okay, Carlos, he prefers the little brightly colored floats. A lot of guys like those floats. I like the streamers. They're a little bit easier for me to see way out in the distance. Again, it's just a matter of preference, but obviously you need something on the line to indicate exactly where your bait is, may it be the float or the streamer. From there, we've got 10 to 12 feet of 60-pound diamond presentation fluorocarbon. Really abrasion resistant, completely or nearly invisible, but that doesn't matter very much in this scenario because, again, this leader primarily is going to be completely out of the water. But we like that stiffness in that fluorocarbon leader. And as I mentioned earlier, during the wintertime, big king mackerel, wahoo, these toothy predators are always a possibility. So we always include about an 18-inch trace of 60-61-pound wire leader. I connect that to my fluorocarbon, to my 60-pound fluorocarbon with a small Albright knot, very streamlined, no additional terminal tackle there. And I've got the entire rig finished off with a BMC 80 live bait hook. This is a J hook. If we were specifically targeting sailfish, then we would only be fishing the circle hooks. But we're out here looking for dolphin, kings, wahoo, just about anything. I mean, we're out here meat fishing today. So the J hook is just a perfect scenario. But I'll tell you what, if you spend the time, if you're rigged right, you're gonna catch them.
High performance hulls designed for speed, comfort, and durability. Custom features and accessories designed for every taste. A brilliantly engineered machine designed to catch more fish. Presenting the remarkable lineup from SeaVee Boats.
Secure any size boat simply and safely with a self-adjusting Tide Slide mooring system. Tide Slide's vertical movement absorbs any motion and allows your boat to be securely held in place while the wind, waves, and tide do their thing. Easy to install, maintenance-free, and hurricane-proven. Take the guesswork out of conventional tie-ups and eliminate slack lines forever. Tide Slide, safe, simple, and secure.
Tired of empty coolers? Book an overnight trip aboard the 100-foot Yankee Captains to the world-famous Dry Tortugas and catch trophy snapper, grouper, king mackerel, and more. Fishing these rich waters for 25 years, let Captain Greg Mercurio and his dedicated crew put you on a hot bite. Fish around the clock or relax on the spacious upper deck. With full galley and huge fish boxes, the only thing you'll need to bring is your appetite for action. Now sailing from Key West, Florida, year-round.
Introducing SeaDeck, a shock-absorbent, non-skid material manufactured from UV-protected foam specifically formulated for marine applications. SeaDeck's comfortable and durable surface protects your deck, reduces noise, and improves the look and value of any boat. Available in a range of colors, SeaDeck is fully customizable and easy to apply with a marine-grade peel-and-stick adhesive. Visit SeaDeck.com for a complete line of retail products. Surprisingly affordable, incredibly versatile.
Got a bite on the flat line here. Let's lock it up. There we go, we're tight, we're tight. That's why we fish the flat lines also. Okay, because you just never know when something's gonna crush one of those flat lines instead of the kite baits. And I'll tell you what, we were overdue on this. But just by having that other rod out, you know, again, you pick off that one extra fish, that one fish can make a big, big difference. This was on a goggle eye on a flat line. Definitely not a sailfish or a dolphin, hasn't jumped. If I had to guess, I'd say maybe a king. But that's a good sign when you're catching them kingfish mixed in. That means there's bait in the area. It's definitely not a bad thing. And this time of the year, we always fish wire. There's always a possibility of a big king mackerel, wahoo. So I'm always fishing a trace of wire during the wintertime. Nice king, right on the flat line. Oh, he's not done yet. That's a weigher, that's a 20 pounder.
20? I don't know about 20.
High teens.
Yeah, 15.
Come on, it's TV, it's gotta be at least 20.
I'll give him that, yeah, adds 10 pounds.
That's what they say, the camera adds 10 pounds. He's coming over here, Ready?
Yeah.
Wait for the shot.
All right.
There we go. Nice. Dude, that's a fat king right there.
Chunky monkey.
Every bit of 20 pounds right there. I am gonna have one happy neighbor. She's gonna love this fish right there. Just an absolutely gorgeous king mackerel. Just a bycatch when you're out here kite fishing, sail fishing. It's a good one. That's a weigher for a tournament right there for sure. And I mean, you can see the teeth. That's why we fish wire right there. Look at that. There, that's why we fish wire leader. I mean, if we were not fishing wire, that fish would be gone, absolutely gone. King mackerel, a Florida staple, available around the entire state. Great for anglers of all ages, all skill levels. You can catch them trolling, chunking, jigging, kite fishing, of course, live bait fishing. Put up a great fight on the appropriate gear. Not bad, you know, on the dinner table, if you smoke the fish, make some really great smoked fish dip out of them. Some guys like grilled king mackerel steaks, but the key is keeping them well iced and keeping them fresh. Well, that's a nice one right there, baby. Get yourself some of that right there, baby. Right there. All right, let's get this guy on ice. Hey, stay with us. We're gonna jump over to our Ask the Experts segment and answer a couple of questions from our viewers. We'll be right back.
Ask the Experts, presented by Pelagic High Performance Offshore Gear, official apparel of Florida Sport Fishing TV.
Greg Nixon from Miami writes, I just purchased a 23-foot Dusky at the Miami International Boat Show and I'd like to get into kite fishing. What is the best depth of water to fish? My dream is to catch sailfish on my own boat. Greg, let's make your dreams come true. Successful kite fishing is about much more than just particular depth. There are other factors that have to be taken into consideration. Clean blue water is an absolute must, and if you can find that nice clean water along with a distinct color change, that's even better. The presence of bait is also really important. Showering ballyhoo, flying fish, birds working really low to the water, these are all key indicators that can't be ignored. Current is also key. Preferably, we like that northerly current. However, any current is better than just sitting still. Sometimes all of these conditions, Greg, come together in 80 feet of water, and the next day they may all come together in 280 feet of water. So you really have to keep your eyes open and you've got to keep your options open. But I'll tell you what, Greg, the next time you head offshore, do the very best that you can to put together all of these pieces to the puzzle, and before you know it, there'll be sailfish crashing your baits.
Sail's coming up on it right now. He's gonna eat it.
Oh, look at him, look at him, look at him, look at him, look at how sick that is.
Yeah, yeah.
Look at him, he's chasing it, dude. He's on, he's chasing it. Nice.
Are you ready to get hooked up? Whoa. Florida Sport Fishing is the number one resource for the latest tips, tricks, tactics, and techniques for inshore and offshore. Each issue is jam-packed with useful articles, easy-to-follow illustrations, and award-winning photography. Only $30 for 2 years. For immediate home delivery, visit floridasportfishing.com/TV. Subscribe today and receive a free shirt and Florida Sport Fishing Hoorag.
What if navigating was as simple as touch and go? It is that simple. The world's first multi-touch MFT chartplotter, Navnet TZ Touch.
Are you afraid of swirling, burning, or scratching your finish with a power buffer? Want to restore that showroom shine to your car, boat, or RV? Introducing SureHold's award-winning dual-action polisher. Right out of the box, you'll polish like a pro. Traditional buffers spin on one axis, while SureHold's dual-action polisher oscillates in a varying orbit across two axes, protecting your finish while providing a professional shine every time. For a dealer near you or to buy online, visit SureHold.com.
Florida Sport Fishing has been proudly presented by Hooker Electric, the ultimate fishing reel, Tropic Trailer, Florida's largest dealer has the right trailer at the right price, Fishity, the maps to plan, the tools to catch, the option to brag, Ocean LED, the only choice in underwater lighting, and Frigid Rigid, from 35 to 300 quarts, the finest coolers and freezers on the water.
I'm tight.
Are you?
Tight, right there, dude. He just grabbed it. Literally just grabbed it right out of my hand. Absolutely crushed it. I'm coming up. What did I tell you? Any second, all can change.
Yeah.
feet off of Boca on the kite bait, baby. Now you can really get a good look at those dentures. VMC80 live bait hooked, did its job. Savage killers, that's what these king mackerel are. Just cruise around, crushing everything that they can catch. Bonitas, pilchards, goggle eyes, they'll eat snapper, they'll eat small Spanish mackerel, they'll eat it all. Not this guy, not anymore. Hey, hopefully you picked up a few tips or tricks on kite fishing. We had an awful good time. Had some sailfish, some nice kings. Don't forget to spend the right amount of time. Rig your outfits right. Make sure you're well prepared. Do it the right way, and you'll certainly achieve success. And if you don't find what you're looking for the first time, don't give up. And remember, to win any of our rods seen on today's episode, check us out on Facebook. We'll see you next week.
To learn more about the tactics and techniques seen on today's show, and to subscribe to Florida Sport Fishing Magazine, visit floridasportfishing.com and get hooked up.